Welcome students, in my class 11, my subject is Mathematics and Statistics. In this lecture, I am introducing to you the index of the mathematics. What is the index of the mathematics of part 2? See here. Chapter number 1. First, chapter number 1 is complex numbers. We earlier seen what are the numbers. And that numbers is different from these number complex numbers. Then we early in the earlier standard we see the natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, fractions, decimals, rational numbers, irrational numbers, and it is the different from these. Second chapter is sequence and series. In 10th standard we see the chapter that is a sequence. We are all unknown to this sequence, and for this sequence next we can see in this class 11, that is series also. In the third chapter there is permutation and combination. Students, you know the addition and multiplication. As like this permutation and combination is, what about the addition? What is the different methods for addition and what is the different methods for multiplication? In the next chapter, methods of induction. In different ways, how we can prove for the number n, for the number n plus 1, for the number n plus 2, the proofs of all the statements. Again, next, binomial theorem. We see the expansion of the algebraic equations. Suppose a plus b bracket square, or in quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, the expansions of a plus b bracket cube. Then how to expand and x a plus b raised to n, or x plus y bracket raised to n bracket raised to n minus 1. In this chapter we clear it. Okay, next chapter is fifth chapter, that is sets and relations. What are the sets and relations? You already studied in the earlier standards also. Next chapter is functions. What are the functions? What are the variables? What are the brackets? How it can be defined? Then in this chapter we study the functions. Next, the limits. What is the limit of one of the variable? How to the variable tends to that number that we study in this chapter. Continuity means, suppose one man goes to the village, but he stops between these two villages. Then it is discontinuous. Continuously when he walks and walks and walks, then it is called as a continuous. Then in this chapter we see how the functions are continuous or not continuous. Next, this chapter depends on these two chapters, limits and continuity. When we get all the formulas for the limits and continuity, then we get the differentiation. What is differentiation? Students, when you give one of the big tasks, then this big task cannot be done like separate, independently. Then this task can be divided into parts and parts and parts. Then this is called as a differentiation, different derivative of the function. Then this process, when we find the derivative of the functions, then it is called as a differentiation. Okay, this is the index of the part 2 of the mathematics. For these chapters, we first know about the symbols. What are the symbols in mathematics and what is the name of that symbols? Okay, let us see the symbols. in earlier standards, you know all the symbols, but some different symbols I am giving here. Students, you know some of the symbols from this. Symbols and name of that symbol. You know the first fundamental symbols, that is plus, minus, multiplication, division. This is called as plus. When two numbers we get given to us, then we add them by using this symbol. We subtract this, or we called it as minus. Multiplication, division. For the Indian standard, we have more symbols. This is called as equal sign. This is called as not equal to. Okay. This symbol is called as square root. Square root of any number. You all seen these symbols in the earlier standards. Okay. I am giving here another more symbols. Symbol name. This symbol is less than any number. This symbol is greater than. These are some basic symbols. Also we take percentage symbol. How to denote the percentage of any number? In this symbol, we can denote the percentage of any number. This symbol is called as therefore. There are so many another symbols are there exist. This symbol is called as there exist. Another next belongs to. This symbol is called as belongs to. Symbol, another symbol and name. This symbol is called as cup symbol or union. Union of two sets. Intersection. This symbol is called as intersection. This symbol is called as subset of the set. This symbol is called as parallel lines. This symbol is called as perpendicular lines. Get it? We have more and more symbols. These are some basic symbols. This is called as a rounded bracket. And this is called as a closed bracket. Rounded bracket. And closed bracket. Next is, we denote for the sets. We denote the say number of the elements in this bracket. This is called as curly bracket. This symbol is called as theta. Theta. This is called as pi. And this is called as phi. I revise all the symbols. What you know about this? The basic symbols for we need for the chapters in this part 2 of the mathematics. Let us go through the numbers. What are the numbers? What is the first chapter of this part 2? This is the complex number. To see the complex number, first chapter of this part 2 of the mathematics, we have to know about the numbers, types of the numbers and properties of the numbers. Types of numbers. First type is natural numbers. Number counting is known to all. Therefore, the numbers 1, 2, 3 and so on, we are counting in this life, are used for counting. The numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, so on, so on, we are used for counting. Therefore, these numbers are called as counting numbers or natural numbers. These numbers are called as natural numbers. Just I am recalling the numbers. You know all about this. Second is whole number. What are the whole numbers? The natural numbers along with 0. The whole numbers are natural numbers. Natural numbers along with 0 are called as whole numbers. And these numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. These are infinite numbers. This is also called as collection of the natural numbers along with 0. It's called as a collection of whole numbers. Next number is integers. What are the integers? The natural numbers along with only positive and counting from 1. But these integers are taking the negative numbers also. Suppose this is 0. 1, 2, 3, 4. We are counting like that. In the opposite side, the numbers are minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. And this set of numbers is called as a integers. Therefore, integers are collection of the numbers. Collection consisting of natural numbers, 0 and negative of natural numbers. Integers is a collection of natural numbers, 0 and negative numbers. These are like minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2 and so on. These are the integers. Here we have seen some of the types of the numbers. In the next lecture, we go through the next another types of the numbers and the properties of that numbers, and we go to the chapter, that is the complex number. Okay.